Well, in prison, you know, because now I've been, as I said, in prison for 39 years, and I'll probably be in prison for many, many more years, probably maybe for the rest of my life, or unless Jesus comes and takes me out of here, I'm facing, you know, many more years of incarceration. And I'll talk about that in a minute. But one of the earlier experiences I had when I came to prison, I mentioned earlier about how guys used to tease me about the dog and things like that. And I tried to just end that by saying, oh, there was none of that. It was just a lot of misconceptions. But one day in 1979 is what often happens in prison, especially in the maximum security prisons, is inmate violence, which of course is a common thing. And so one inmate, for whatever reason, I guess to make a name for himself, he fashioned a razor to some kind of stick or something and reached through the bars when I was doing my porter's work. I was like a custodian and I was mopping and cleaning, and I got near his bars and he reached out and he slashed my throat. And it turns out he opened up the whole side with the razor. The razor was buried to the hilt practically, and opened up the whole side of the left side of my neck. And next thing you know, so I got this gaping hole in my neck, and I'm like, I'm on the gallery. I'm like, at this time I was about, I think about 26 years old, 25, 26 years old. I was a new jack. I'd only been in prison for maybe a couple of years at the most. So I was like, okay. I didn't feel any pain, just a little sting. It was a very unusual experience. And I realized, oh man, this guy really cut me, because I put my fingers there and my fingers went right inside the neck. I know it sounds gross, but that's the whole side of my neck opened up. So I walk out to where the officers are sitting, because they have their little control booth there where they look through the windows to watch down the galleries. And I'm standing there, says, listen, I've been cut. And I actually had a smile, kind of like a smile on my face, and says, hey, I guess somebody doesn't like me. And the officers look, oh my goodness. So they walk me across prison grounds to the infirmary. I have to go to the infirmary now to be stitched up, because I've got this massive wound. And the officer's like in a state of shock. So this one officer, it was Officer Montgomery. He walks alongside me, and we go down the steps outside into the other building to walk me through. And there's other inmates in the hallway who see me. You know, they know me, because they're working in the same building as me. And I say, oh my God, Dave, what happened to you? I says, man, someone tried to take me out, you know. And a typical prison thing, you know. And I walked all the way to the infirmary. I didn't lose that much blood, amazingly. And I sat down in on the table there, you know, the doctor, when the doctor examines you. And the doctor comes out and looks at me and says, oh man. And he's looking at the wound. He says, gotta stitch you up. I was fully conscious. As I said, I didn't lose much blood, even though the whole side of my neck was opened up. And he says, I can't believe they missed you. He missed your carotid artery. Because he could see all the veins in that particular artery right there. He says, they missed your carotid artery. He says, I don't know how they did that. He says, man, you wouldn't even be here right now if he hit you that. Oh, yeah. And I'm like joking with him. I'm like, well, you know. And he stitches me up. And then they put me in the infirmary, because we have to keep you for about a week or so. I stayed about a week because they thought possibility of infection. It was a pretty gross and serious wound. But because I didn't lose any blood, you know, I was fine. They didn't have to take me to the outside hospital. The prison hospital in Attica is like a mass unit, because guys come in every day with stab wounds, cuts, this, that. That's prison life. So I was just another one of the wounded, walking wounded, you know. And while I was in the hospital, you know, the state police and whoever else, other law enforcement agencies, would come into the room I was in, because they had to interrogate me to find out, you know, who did this. And, you know, back then I was young, but I knew about the prison code. And so they spent hours trying to get me to talk, and, you know, I wouldn't tell them who did it, And after about a week, they let me out. I was healing up, you know, they took the stitches out, and I went back to work just where I was before. But the interesting thing that happened was after that, when the inmates saw that I stood my ground and wouldn't squeal, quote unquote, squeal or rat on the guy that did it, I earned a lot of respect. So word went out throughout the whole prison that Dave is a stand-up guy. And that, in other words, that was my test. It wasn't something I expected or wanted, but it turned out to be a test. And it proved something to the men that, you know, I can do my time and be a man. I know it sounds almost silly and petty, but that was the code back then. You lived and died by your reputation in prison, you know. If you had a bad reputation, you had a tough way to go. If you had a good reputation as a stand-up guy who wouldn't snitch on anybody and minded your business, you were cool. So I became, like to many of the guys, someone they could say, we could trust him. He's one of us. You know, he's not going to talk when under pressure. I know it sounds trivial and almost silly, but in the minds of the prisoners, my fellow prisoners and my peers, that was a big deal. So it put me up to a whole new level of trust and respect within the facility. And in the end, I could look back all these years later, even though it was literally a close brush with death, because by this man just somehow missed that artery, it turned out to my benefit. Till this very day, guys have respect for me because of that one incident. It sounds kind of silly to have to live that way, but that's just the way the inmate code is. So that was one of the ways that, even though it was a bad thing, good came out of it. I can't explain that, but God's mercy was on me.